right, for those of you who don't know me, my name is John Rutkowski. I'm the director of the program here at the County College of Morris, and I want to welcome all of you and thank you for coming. So we're going to get the program started in short order. So I'm going to ask Dr. Iacono, who's the president of the college, County College of Morris, to do some introductory remarks.
Thank you. Good evening. We heard a little bit of celebration. It sounded like this is a rowdy group with us to celebrate tonight, so don't hold back. Do you know them? Okay, good. And you heard the override already that take all the photos that you want this evening. This is a night of celebration. And students, congratulations. We are here for you. It's been exciting having you in this program. We know that you have worked very, very hard, probably harder at times than you ever thought you could, and endure a little more stress than you've ever had to and so forth. But I'll bet you also worked really closely as a group and got each other to where you are this evening. So congratulations, it's absolutely tremendous. I'm gonna recognize some individuals for a moment, and then I wanna come back and talk with you for a second as well. But you're gonna hear some individuals introduced tonight. I'm gonna start some of that, and Professor Rakowski's gonna do some of that as well. You'll be hearing from, but it's my great honor to introduce first, our chairman of the Board of Trustees for the County College of Morris, Mr. Paul Lasitra. And our Vice President for Student Development and Enrollment Management, Dr. Betty Simmons. And our Vice President for Professional Studies and Applied Sciences, Mr. Patrick Enright. Students, we're here to celebrate you this evening. But there are a lot of people to thank. I introduced a couple with a great deal of appreciation for the extraordinary work that they do. You have worked very, very closely with your professors, some of the support staff at the college. Perhaps you found your way into the library, into the tutoring center, and different support areas of the college. But you don't get to see everyone who's really, really working hard for you behind the scenes. And I can tell you, County College of Morris has the absolute best Board of Trustees that works extremely hard behind the scenes. And at the core of what they do is you. And I cannot tell you how many times I hear them continuously in our meetings. We will never compromise on quality. We want to make sure our students have the absolute best quality education that could possibly be provided. And it's a little bit selfish because we're relying on you. You are our future. Should we find ourselves in your need, we want to make sure that you are the absolute best. So their hard work benefits all of us at CCM, all of us across the county as well. And we know that you've achieved all of that. But I also want to recognize not only the individuals I introduced, an absolute tremendous faculty. You've worked with Professor Rakowski, you've worked with Professor Fong and others. I'm hugely proud of them. I know you are as well. But your first teachers are sitting all throughout this room, for many of you. They're your parents, your grandparents, your aunts, your uncles. Your great supporters and people who taught you along the way and probably taught you perseverance as well are in this room. They're your friends, your cousins, your spouses, okay, your significant others. So would you join me in giving them a great round of applause for helping you be here as well? I'm going to keep my remarks fairly brief because there's a lot tonight, and what I'm going to say won't be nearly as memorable or as impressive as what you're going to hear from others this evening and what you're going to see this evening. We want to allow maximum time for that. But students, I simply want to say and urge one thing. I want to impress upon you, and I'm sure others have, but I don't think it can be offered too many times. And that is, remember, while you possess tremendous knowledge and skill and the ability to restore good health to individuals, to make people more comfortable, to reassure them, please remember that it's not merely the knowledge that you have and the skill sets you have. It's the compassion that you bring for people into this profession. Because when you see us tonight, we're by and large at our best, but you may have occasion to see us when we're not at our best, when we're scared, when we're struggling. And that's when we're also relying on you for not only the knowledge, not only the skill, but for the compassion that you can bring forward as well. And so I ask you to always remember that as you go forward and as you're working. We do rely on you. We value you. And you're nearly there. There's one more piece, or two, I was told, coming up as well. And we know what that is, right? It is those boards. Yes, okay. But you've made it this far, and you're going to thrive on those boards as well. And we have a longstanding tradition at County College of Morris, and that is if there is a 100% pass rate on those exams, then we have you come back, and we do a celebratory dinner with you as well. It has to be 100%, not 99%. So please, everyone, work hard. We want to celebrate with you. We don't want you to be the one person that kept that away from us, okay? Work hard. I look forward to seeing, no pressure. I look forward to seeing all of you again for a repeat celebration, and congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Iacono. Let me just introduce again Paul Lasitra, who's the chairman of the Board of Trustees.
I want to welcome everybody on behalf of the Board of Trustees of County College. You know, we don't get involved in the day-to-day education of the students, but I do know one thing that we all realize, that this is probably one of the most difficult courses that we teach and programs that we have at County College of Morris. So this is no small accomplishment, what you've accomplished. I know Dr. Kai kind of put the pressure on you about the test, but you're going to ace that. It's all right. I know it. It's going to be fine. You're definitely prepared after you've left County College. I know between the faculty and the staff and everything else that our students are definitely prepared for the workforce. I just want to welcome you to the daily grind after you leave here, and you'll be in the workforce. You know, I could say the same things I say to the nurses when they graduate, is that there's no accident that you're here. This is a special profession. This is very responsible. And your path was destined to be here. I like to call it a gift from God, myself. You're going to be a special person in a special field doing special things. So all I can say is God bless you and good luck.
If you had the agenda, you see that Dean Maraska is on the agenda. Unfortunately, she can't be here tonight, but I know that she would wish all of the students very well. And if you don't, you probably don't know her, but she's a nurse. And if you understand what critical care, healthcare is all about, it's all about teamwork. And I think there's no one who appreciates the presence and the congeniality of being able to work together as respiratory therapists and nurses. They work essentially the same way. They have different roles, but they have to make things work for the patient. It has to be a team for us to work well. And there are a lot of other healthcare professions that get involved, but nobody that's closer than the nurses and the respiratory therapists in the hospital. All right, so next on the agenda, I would like for Dr. Betty Simmons to come up, and she'll talk a little bit about some of our academic awards. And these students have actually done an incredible job, and Dr. Simmons will talk about the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society.
Thank you, Professor Rakowski. Hello, graduates. Hi, this is awesome, right? We are so excited. They're just lovely. They do it in unison. This is great. So that means, Dr. Iacona, they will help one another get through that awesome test. So I have the pleasure of talking to you all a little bit about the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society, but if Professor Rakowski would give me a little bit of privilege, I want to tell you all how important you are. 3 years ago, my mother passed away, and she had multiple organ failure. She suffered for a very long time with COPD. At the time, I had absolutely no idea what COP even stood for, let alone what it was, and learned over the years that she was struggling with it, what COPD was. The times that she spent in the hospital, and you were right, there were a team of medical professional, healthcare professionals that worked with her. She had organ failure with heart, lung, kidneys, you name it. The time that we spent with the respiratory therapist was absolutely amazing. And I was very proud she was at Marstown Medical Center. The majority of the individuals that worked with her were from the County College of Mars program. And so I want to thank the faculty, Professor Rakowski, Professor Fong, for doing such an extraordinary job in training our students, because the critical care that they provided lengthened my mother's life, allowed her to have a lot more stability, and give us a lot more time with her. And the compassion, as well as the care and the concern, the treatment, was just amazing, and I was constantly impressed. And so thank you to our faculty for doing an extraordinary job. You all have been taught by some of the finest faculty in this state, and you should be very proud of that. So as Dr. Iacona asked you to thank your family and friends, I'd like you all to stand and give a thank you to our faculty here at CCM. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Thank you. So take that with you. You may be seated. Now, Phi Theta Kappa, for those of you who are new to County College of Mars, is our National Honor Society, and CCM has a chapter here on campus. It is one of the most prestigious honor societies among community colleges in the country. It is not easy to become a member of Phi Theta Kappa because you need to achieve at least a minimum grade point average of 3.50 or higher. And so if you think 4.0 is a perfect grade point average, and you've got to have a 3.5 in one of the most rigorous academic programs that we have here at the college, these individuals have really worked very hard. And so I would like to recognize a number of students who have achieved that pinnacle of academic success. And I'm going to apologize in advance to anybody's name that I butcher, I will do my best to recognize you. So when I call your name, if you would please stand. And of course, they're helping a little bit because some of them have their PTK stoles on, so that's a little tell right there. Giata Aswala. Diana Blizzardi. Agnieszka Lukasik. Bergavi Malina. Phoebe McNamara. Ellen Thomby. And Nisha Trivedi. Many congratulations to these students who have agreed to be members of Phi Theta Kappa, who have pledged a life of service and leadership, scholarship, and community, and that they will continue to do really well, not just on the academic scale, but in contributing to our society. So ladies, thank you so very much and congratulations. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Dr. Simmons. I'm going to change slides for a second because I want to talk about what it was like a little bit in the early years of the profession, like pretty much when I started. So when I started in the profession, which was well into the last century, I started in 1969 as an on-the-job trained technician. Then I was fortunate enough to have a wonderful mentor who directed me towards going to a professional education. I had to leave the state. There were no programs in the state back then. So I had to go to Lancaster, Pennsylvania. That's where I trained. And I graduated in 1970. Now, what was it like when I was a student? If you look up there, you'll see that the book on the left side of the screen, as you look at it, was the first edition of that textbook, which is what I used as a primary textbook when I was a student. On the right side is the latest edition of that textbook. And you can just see the difference in size and the fact that there's a second book as a workbook with it. So those are actually two of the primary texts that we used in the profession. I got an Associate of Science degree. These guys are students are getting an Associate of Applied Science degree. Essentially the same, not much difference between the two. But I tell you that the stuff that they're learning now wasn't even thought of back then. Wasn't even dreamed of back then. So when they say that these guys have a tough row to hoe in the same amount of time, it's really incredible what they need to learn. And they've accomplished that. I mean, I had almost 50 years to learn what they learned in 11 months. So that'll give you a little understanding of what it was like. Other things that are different, so in addition to the changes in textbooks and the volumes. And if you ever seen them come to class, they have full backpacks. I don't know how they do it, especially the little girls. They're incredible, and they won't leave one book at home. They bring so if they got 5 minutes, they can go to the library and study, and they just put in a lot of time. And when we say full time, this is more than 15 credits. They take 12 credits a semester, but it really amounts to 40 to 50 hours of work a week for them. So they really have to work very hard. This is another difference between when I was a student. That was my calculator on the left side of the screen. I don't know if any of you are that old to remember what a slide rule looked like. And on the right side of the screen is one of the more modern calculators. The calculators that they have today are actually more powerful than some of the computers that they used to get, that everybody was talking about landing on the moon. These calculators that they have now are more powerful than those computers were back then. The other thing that happened was there were changes in credential. This is a copy of my registry certificate, and I don't know if you can see it. I hope you can. But if you look at the top, it says American Registry of Inhalation Therapists. Now, the new certificates say American Registry of Respiratory Therapists. So I only learned half of what they know. We only learned how to breathe in. Over the course of those 50 years, we learned how to exhale. So that's another big difference. Progress. So this was some of the equipment that I used when I was a student. And you look at the one on the extreme left side. It's kind of looks like an old washing machine, but that's a ventilator. Okay, the one in the middle we used as a ventilator too. They're different types. One's a volume ventilator, one's a pressure ventilator. The one on the right was slightly more modern, maybe 5 years after the one on the left. The other thing you'll notice about them is that they're all analog. You have to actually turn dials to make things work. So the cycle of the development over those years, it used to be where we would get a new ventilator every 5 or 6 years, new technology would come out. Now, the technology is moving so fast, you can't keep up with it. It's changing every year for the most part. These are what some of the newer ones look like. The one on the left is one of the standard critical care ventilators. It's one of the newest ones on the market. We're fortunate enough, through the good graces of the college, that we have one of those for our students to use in the lab, actually two of them in the lab. So they get to learn these things in the lab before they get to practice them in clinical. You don't know how much more that means to the teachers when they're trying to teach them in clinical, that they're already familiar with the devices. The one in the middle is kind of a high-frequency ventilator. I won't bother to explain it, but you see that there's actually an oscilloscope on the bottom of it. And the one on the right is another high-frequency ventilator. The one on the right is capable of delivering 15 breaths a second to little babies, which is some of the standards that we use now. 15, you know, we breathe about 20 times a minute, and we're ventilating these little tiny babies at about 15 times a second. This is, she's gonna hate me if she sees this on YouTube, but this is one of our former students from a few years ago, one of a wonderful student, Rihanna. She's living in Texas, so maybe there'll be some delay. But this is, this is during her orientation, and she's learning how to set all this equipment up. All of this equipment is gonna go on one baby, and she's gonna be responsible for it. Okay, so that's another big difference. So I'm gonna, that'll be the end of that part of the presentation. I'll come back later. And now I would like to introduce Ken Capek. Ken Capek is a friend of mine for a long time. He's the director of respiratory therapy and ECG, and they probably threw an EEG just for as a kicker, at Newbridge Medical Center in Paramus, New Jersey, or just outside of Paramus, actually. He's also the chair of the New Jersey Board of Respiratory Care, so very special guest.
Thank you, John. 1969. Wow. I was 1970. I thought I was the oldest practitioner. You got me beat. And I see your registry number is 1961. Mine was 5,000 something. See, he was the original founder. Congratulations, everybody.
Thank you.
So, you graduated. You got to take your test. Got to get licensed, got to find a job, and that's where the new chapter starts in your book of life. And you have to write it. Only you can write that chapter. Let me help you write that chapter. Three things. Two of them were already mentioned. Knowledge. You never stop learning. You know, I'm losing brain cells as I stand here. So if I don't read and practice and learn things, if I'm losing and I'm not gaining, that's not a good thing. So you always got to stay fresh, and things are always changing. And not just respiratory. Learn about everything you possibly can. You know, in my career, I've learned about sleep medicine. I've learned about hyperbaric oxygen. I've opened up centers for hyperbaric oxygen. You know, I've at 50, I learned how to scuba dive. I became an instructor. So you just keep learning, and you won't get Alzheimer's and get boring. So keep learning. That's important. Second thing is, was mentioned also, compassion. Got to have compassion. When I interview somebody, I want to know the knowledge, I want to see the transcript, but I want to know what they're going to tell me in terms of how they care about people and their compassion. Also, compassion is also empathy. Empathy is not sympathy. If you're a patient, you don't want sympathy. Don't feel sorry for me. I want empathy. I want some understanding of what I'm going through a little bit, like in my shoes, if that's possible. Sometimes the best way to show empathy is to listen to people. Just listen to your patient. Right? The last thing, so here's the other thing that's not there, is courage. You're going to be in a new job, a new environment, a new culture, new people, and you come with your values. The most important value is courage. Because without that, you won't stand up for your other values, right? It's real important to have that courage and stand against peer pressure and others that may say, well, we do it this way, but you know the right way to do it, and you have to stand up for it. That's tough. That's a risk. But that's important, you know. So don't worry about it. Do what you think is right. Don't worry about criticism. Socrates said, if you don't want to be criticized, do nothing, right? Don't say anything, keep quiet, and be nothing. You don't want to be nothing, you want to be something. You want to be the best you can be. So again, you're in a great profession, a great field, because I know that you have an opportunity every day to help people. I also know when you help people, you're helping yourself. You make yourself better, too. So that's a great bonus, and you have that great opportunity now. So congratulations, and good luck.
Okay, thanks, Ken. All right, next part on the agenda is some recognition of some other academic achievement. Now, Dr. Simmons talked about the Phi Theta Kappa Society, which is an honor society across the country. We have our own chapter here on campus, one of the best in the country also, most active in the country, I think, in some respects. But we also have an honor society just for respiratory therapy. So we have some students who have done exceptionally well in their professional education to date. So we're gonna give them some special recognition. So I'm just gonna give you their names, and then I'll actually give them their honors when we get going in a little bit, as far as the other presentations go. Now, let me see, what did I do with the list? All right, so these are the Lambda Beta inductees. So if you just stand up when I call your name. Jody Asawala. Diana Blizzard. Cassidy Grady. Yeah. What'd you do, stop in the mall on the way here and pick people up? Daniel Hosler. Nicole Lysenga. Bhargavi Molina. Marilyn Mayorga. Another fan club. Phoebe McNamara. Diana Rangel Pineda. Joel Seabee. Darren Swaza. And Nisha Trivedi. Professor Fong Grace to come up. She's going to help us with the presentations. I'll give you everything else. All right, so so we're going to present the class of 2019. So these are their solo pictures. Again, this slide set was put together by Cassidy Grady and Jennifer. All right, so as I call your name, you can come up to Professor Fong, and she will give you your pin. Okay, so Sahar Al-Faraj. I can bring them to you if you want. Jody Aswala. Now, if you remember, Jody was one of the ones who was recognized for her professional education. So she's got an honor cord from the Lambda Beta Society. That's what the difference was there. Okay. Diana Blizzard. Jennifer Cardona. Mary Cardona. Justin Gomes. Cassidy Grady. Daniel Higgins. Daniel Hostler. Congratulations. Agnieszka Lukaszewicz. Nicole Azenga. Bhargavi Molina. Marshall McKilling. Marilyn Mayorga. Guys are getting excited. Phoebe McNamara. Did they spell your name right? I don't think so. Yeah, I know, but I don't know. All right, where's Cassie? We'll get you fixed up later. All right, this is Maria Payaras Urina. Okay. All right, Diana Rangel Pinilla. Joel Sibi. Woo! Darren Swaza. Lagita Tamulunyaini. Ellen Tambi. Nisha Trivedi. Marjorie Trujillo. And Catherine Vogel. But before we move on, there's one important thing that I want the students to do. In the healthcare professions for a while, especially in medical schools, they talk about a white coat ceremony. So rather than having them wear their caps and gowns, we're going to ask them to don their white lab coats. And you guys can stand up. Now the so when you like those white coats, huh? So white coat ceremony has been a tradition, probably more in the field of medicine since probably the early 1990s, but it's becoming a rite of passage for a lot of other healthcare professions, and it kind of signifies, I'm not going to ask them to say the Hippocratic Oath or anything like that, but it's a rite of passage for the health science students that we want to be able to encourage them, as other people have already talked about. It's kind of like a psychological contract for professionalism and empathy. So it kind of signifies the movement from one phase of your learning to the next phase, which is becoming a professional. So it emphasizes the importance of a foundation of a mission for the profession, education, research, patient care, and service. So I want to congratulate all of them on taking the next step in their life, which becoming a professional. And it doesn't end there, as Mr. Capek said. You got to learn for the rest of your life. And just remember that down the road, those bachelor's degrees are going to be coming. So we got to keep learning. All right, so next, you guys can sit down. I'm going to take this down for a second. And then I'm going to ask Nisha Trivedi. Nisha Trivedi is the president of our class, the Respiratory Therapy Club. So she was elected president. She's got some remarks that she wants to make.
Good evening, fellow classmates, Professor Rakowski, Professor Fong, family, friends, and everyone that can join us today on our special day. My name is Nisha Trivedi, and I'm the president of this amazing respiratory class. We went from being strangers to becoming family throughout the years. I remember when I first met Professor Rakowski when I was interested in the respiratory program. I was so nervous because this was something I really wanted to do, but I didn't know if I was going to get accepted. Professor Rakowski continued to reassure me that I had nothing to worry about, and once I got in, I took that positive attitude throughout my college journey, and even shared that with the friends that I made throughout the year. Learning about respiratory and everything that was involved made me feel like I was going into respiratory distress. But I powered through, and here I am today, with no distress, but recovering from pneumonia. With all jokes aside, we have all different age groups, from students straight out of high school to my 40 plus group. I know this has been a struggle for all age groups, and we worked so hard to get to this point. But I really want to commend the 40 plus group. You all know who you are. You all have truly inspired me in your own special ways. I can't even imagine how you do it, from being married, having kids, going to clinical, and still making time to study. I thought I had it rough, waking up at 4:30 every morning and having a long commute. But after meeting these strong women, it encouraged me that anything is possible. Being around my classmates, especially Marjorie, and seeing the effort that put into learning respiratory was motivating to see. This mindset helped me go outside my comfort zone to become the president so I can be a leader for myself and for my fellow classmates. Steve Jobs said it best, "Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary." Lastly, I want to thank all my family and friends for all their unconditional love and support throughout the years. Congratulations to the class of 2019. Let's show the world what we're made of. Thank you.
Thank you, Nisha. Now I'd like to call up to the podium Professor Grace Fong. She has some faculty remarks for us.
So, grads, you've made it. Okay. Good evening, everyone. Distinguished guests, friends, family, and Diane Pierce from our advisory board committee is also here. As John stated, I'm the director of clinical education here at County College of Morris. This day is a momentous one for all our graduates. Graduates, the long hours, hard work, and you have put into your studies and are evidence of your achievements today. Each and every one of you should be proud of yourselves achieving this degree. I'm pregnant, so I'm a little emotional, okay? So bear with me. However, the hard work and pride is not yours alone. Your hands-on learning occurred at several teaching facilities, including Morristown Medical Center, Robert Wood Barnabas Health, Newark Beth Israel, and Barnabas Livingston, Hackensack University Medical Center, Overlook Medical Center, as well as including two specialty rotations at Wanacue Rehabilitation Center and St. Clair's Denville and Dover. Along with Professor Rakowski and I, there have been several clinical instructors counseling and teaching all of you along the way. We must also credit these wonderful clinical instructors that have provided hours of instruction in the clinical setting. I would like to take this moment to thank their educators. Some of them are here tonight, some of them are not. Kunjaman Matai, Monica Bianco, Dr. Albert Heuer, Karen Casey, Gainda Ramprasad, Jaseel Thomas, Malou Whitney, Amanda Vasquez, Salma Sanchez, Michael Sterling, Jeremy Salo, and Katie Heath for sharing their professionalism, their knowledge, their dedication, and their passion for this profession. We share in their joy of your achievement, the pride that comes with the knowledge you have learned, and the excitement of taking the next steps of your respiratory careers. So, as Dr. Seuss says, you're off to great places. Today is your day, and your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. So congratulations, graduates, and congratulations to all of our clinical instructors, our educators, Professor Rakowski, and anyone who has supported you along the way. So I'd like to take this moment for you to say thank you to all of them.
All right, thank you, Grace. And thank you to all the clinical instructors who did come today. I believe that we have a wonderful group of clinical instructors. They do a great job, and I know the students really appreciate them. Now I have a few more remarks, and then we'll move on with the rest of the ceremony. These students, these graduates that are here today, we've already said this several times, so I just want to reiterate it. They're going to learn much more in the future. I've told you how much more I learned in the 50 years. Can you imagine how much more these young ladies and gentlemen are going to learn in the next 5, 10, 15 years? You know, my generation and the generations after me have done a lot to move things along, but as I told you before, things are going to be moving much more fast, much more quickly, so they're going to have to keep up the pace, and it's going to be a challenge at times, but I know that they can do it. So the future might seem more like even the postulations of the wonderful writers, the futurists, like Isaac Asimov, Gene Roddenberry, Orson Welles, James Cameron. They had the vision to see what was going to be happening in the future. If anybody watched Star Trek and you've been to a modern medical center today, you see some of the things that happening in Star Trek, 10 years, 15 years ago, are now happening in hospitals every single day. It's not just also about learning about the lungs anymore. They're going to have to gain a deeper understanding of all of the organ systems. Right? You can't separate, we often say that we can't separate the heart and the lungs. Well, you can't separate the brain from that. You can't separate the kidneys from that. You can't separate the liver from that. All of these organs have a lot to do with each other. And these students have been gaining some knowledge, but they're going to have to gain a lot more about the interactions between those organ systems. So all organ systems are going to be involved. And let me just get back on my notes here. We also learned that we can control a lot of what happens in the body just by learning how to breathe. If there's anybody in the audience who has an understanding about Ayurvedic medicine. The yogis, some of them are so good that just by controlling their breathing, they can actually stop their hearts from beating. It's incredible what the mind can do. A respiratory system in the brain is the only system that integrates both different types of nervous systems. So sympathetic nervous system and the other nervous systems are all integrated through the brain. And when you control your breathing, we already know that you can control your blood pressure. You control a lot of other things. So we're going to see a lot in the future where we can do a lot more just by learning how to breathe and being able to control what's happening. I honestly believe that we can teach people to control asthma just by teaching them how to breathe. So it's going to be interesting. And as Ken mentioned before, you have to have an understanding of the patient. Not only the patient, but the patient's families, the people that are important to the patient. He mentioned before that you have to understand sympathy, you have to understand empathy, and the feelings. Now, we know about sympathy is when you can just say you feel bad for somebody. Right? Empathy is when you start to think a little bit about them. But compassion is what brings everything together, because when you're compassionate, you know what's happening, you can see what's happening, you feel those things that the patient feels, but you do something about it. That's what compassion means. You do something about it. So it requires some action. And the other thing that you have to do, in addition to understanding the patient, you have to understand yourself. You have to be able to effectively regulate yourself. Some of the situations that they may have been exposed to in the hospital are really disturbing to some people. So you got to be able to regulate how you feel about things in order to function. You have to learn what we call, and I've talked about this before in other places, but a little bit about emotional intelligence. We have academic intelligence is one thing, but emotional intelligence is where you learn to manage yourself, self-regulate, and be able to understand what's going on inside you. How does what you're doing every day affect you? And then being able to control that. And one thing I did a video with Steve Adubato. I don't know if any of you guys remember who that is. He's a noted author, motivational speaker. And one of the things that he's always saying is that change is constant. There's nothing you can do about it. Things are going to change. Right? Growth, on the other hand, requires a conscious decision to do something about the change. So that's what these guys are going to be against. And you have to be aware that things are going to be changing very rapidly in the few years. So 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, it's going to be a different world. And these guys will be able to handle that. All right, so let me... next part of the program that I want to do is to give some recognition. We have one special recognition item that we want to take care of, and that's Dr. Goldschlag, Jack Goldschlag. He's been the medical director of this program through various iterations. It's changed over the years. So he's been the medical director for over 30 years, so well into the mid-80s, and he's been here for every transition, whether it's an accrediting system, whether it's adding schools, transitioning schools in or out. He's always been there for us. So I want to present to Dr. Goldschlag a token of our appreciation. You want to come up and... It says on here, County College of Mars, Jack Goldschlag, DOFCCP, Respiratory Therapy Program Medical Director, in recognition of your dedication and service as the Medical Director for the respiratory therapy program at County College of Morris for over 30 years, and it was presented in 2019. Thank you so much for everything that you do. And best wishes in your retirement. I'm sure you'll find something interesting to do, but you're always welcome back here.
Thank you very much.
This is, he's got to be careful. It's a little bit, it's not. Okay. You want to say something? Or?
I do. I've watched the classes over many years. I see our graduates work in the hospitals. I couldn't be more proud of the group. The collective accomplishments of the group are just quite remarkable. I've seen technology advance as if it's a rocket ship, and it will affect you, as everyone has said. I have to congratulate everyone and wish you the best. You have started on a very, very fulfilling career, and I wish everyone the best.
Hey, thank you, Dr. Goldschlag, and all the best in your retirement. Are there any physicians in the audience? We might need a medical director. Now I got a few other thank yous that I want to make some recognition. We had some student volunteers. These are students who are going to be coming into next year's group. They're going to be the graduates of 2020. So those were the people who are outside helping out and giving some guidance. So Matthew Heldak, Maya Kingston, Shannon Lobb, Lighty Londano, and Olga Shabina were here today to help things out. They didn't have to be. They volunteered to do this, and they're going to be coming into next year's group. So get a sense that there's some leadership qualities there. So important stuff. Other people to thank, Michelle Lee and her daughter Maggie, who helped with all the refreshments that are out there. Also, Mike Fong, Professor Fong's husband, and her wonderful daughter, Mia, who are helping out with all the refreshments. A special thank you to Cassidy Grady and Jennifer Cardona for the presentation slides that we had, and the accompanying music, which somewhere along the line I accidentally shut off, I think. But they did a great job. Again, all of the slides were done by the students today. So I want to thank Nisha Trivedi as the president of class for her remarks on behalf of the class. I have to thank my wife, Joanne, who was out there helping with refreshments. And she also put together all of the presentation components for us. So thank you. And then mostly I want to thank Professor Fong, who's been a tremendous resource for me over the years. We're obviously going to lose her for a little while, but I can't wait for her to come back. So we had some good things happen during this year, and some of the things that I'll remember. One of our students actually became a U.S. citizen this year. There was also another student who somehow ended up getting married in the middle of the program. So where'd she go? Where's Nicole, who's over there? And also a member of our group ended up somehow getting pregnant. So it's so good things happening all around. I have to thank these guys I don't think they even realize it, how important a part of my life they become over the last 11 months. I think somebody remarked before, I don't remember who, maybe it was Grace, we actually, over those 11 months, and again, I don't see most of them before that because they're either taking classes at different schools or they're in different parts of the program completing their prerequisites. But I get to see them for 11 months straight. Not so bad for me. I think it's terrible for them, though, to have to see me every day for 11 months. But they've been great, and I honestly have to thank them for being such an important part of my life over the last year. And you guys, wonderful people you are. Again, we're like a family over those 11 months. Sometimes we're a little dysfunctional, but for the most part, we do pretty well. Okay, so I guess we're ready to adjourn. Do we have our recessional music? So please exit in an orderly fashion.